Hi guys, welcome to lesson 5.3, slope intercept form. Our objective for today is that I can write linear equations using slope intercept form, and that I can graph linear equations in slope intercept form. Now, our vocabulary, this whole slope intercept form idea, what is it? Well, it's this form, y equals mx plus b, where m is our slope, and B is our y-intercept. All right, our essential understanding is that you can use the slope and y-intercept of a line to write and graph an equation of the line. So for problem one, we are just going to be identifying slope and y-intercept in our equations. So in letter A, our slope is -1/2. And our y-intercept is a +3. Okay. Remember, the sign in front of a number is connected to the number. So for letter B, our slope is a +3, and our y-intercept is at -6. So I want you guys to try letters A and B on your own. All right. Letter A, y equals 3/2 x plus 6. Our slope is 3/2. And our y-intercept is at +6. Letter B, our slope is a +5. And our y-intercept is at -4. All right. Okay, problem number two, writing an equation in slope-intercept form. What is an equation of a line with a slope of 3/2 and a y-intercept of -1? So we have that generic y equals mx plus b. And we said our slope goes in place of m, so y equals 3/2 x. Our b is our y-intercept, so it's -1. Letter B, what is an equation of a line with a slope of 4 and a y-intercept of 3? So again, we have our y equals mx plus b. That's slope-intercept form. That is something you must memorize. So we plug in our information. Our slope is 4 times x. Our y-intercept is 3, so it's a +3. All right, I want you guys to try letters A and B. So we have, write an equation of a line with a slope of 2 and a y-intercept of 7. So y is equal to 2x plus 7. Slope is 2, y-intercept is a +7. All right, letter B, we have a slope of 4/3 and a y-intercept of 9. So y is equal to 4/3 x plus 9. Okay. Moving on to the next page. Writing an equation from a graph. So here we need to find our two pieces of information. We need to find our slope and we need to find our y-intercept. So there's my y-intercept right there at a +4. So if I have my equation y equals something x, we can say +4 because that's our intercept. And now if I look for another point that I can use, there's one where it crosses a grid line nicely. So I'm going down 1, 2, 3 hops to the right, 1, 2 hops. So it's -3/2. So our equation is -3/2 x plus 4. Our intercept is at 4. We're going down 3 and to the right 2 every single time. So if we follow this pattern down, I should be able to find another point that hits a grid line nicely. So I go down 1, 2, 3 over 2, and I do have a good point. Letter B, same thing. We need to find our y-intercept and we need to find our slope. So there's my y-intercept right there at a positive 2. Another point that I can work with is this one right here at -1, -1. So here I'm going up 1, 2, 3 to the right 1. So we have y equals, my slope is up 3 over 1. 3 over 1 is just 3x plus 2. So we have a positive 2. Now notice, we have a positive slope and we're going up as we go left to right. We had a negative slope, so we're going down as we go left to right. Okay. Want you guys to try letters A and B on your own, and then we'll go over them. So letter A, if I'm looking at points, I've got one point there. I have another point right there. My slope, we're going up 1 and to the right 2. So we have a line, y equals 1/2x, and I'm crossing my y-axis at positive 2. 1/2x plus 2. Okay. Letter B, we have a point right there that's also our y-intercept. And let's see, where's another good point? Well, we could use this point right here. It's another place where it crosses the corner of a grid line. So we're going up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to the right 1, 2, 3. So my equation is going to be y equals 5/3, 5/3x, and my intercept is at a positive 3. Okay. Moving on to problem number 4. Writing an equation from 2 points. So now we need to go ahead and find the slope first and then write the equation of that line. And there's a way to do this, and you'll have another way later. But first, let's find the slope. So we need to do y2 minus y1. So I'm going to do -2 minus -3 over 3 minus 1. So that is going to equal 1/2. -2 minus -3, we're adding. -2 plus 3 is 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. So now I have my equation, y equals mx plus b, and I know a slope, I know coordinates, but I don't know my y-intercept. And I'm not exactly sure how I can come up with that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of my points, and I'm going to plug it in for x and y. So I'm going to plug in -2 for y is equal to m, our slope, which we just calculated, times 3 for x plus b. So we're trying to find what our b value is first. All right, so we have -2 is equal to 3/2 plus b. We don't know what b is yet. So we're going to subtract 3/2 from both sides. 3/2 is just 1.5. And we've got -3.5 is equal to b. So now, remember, we were asked to write an equation for the line that passes through that. So our equation is going to be y equals 1/2x minus 3.5. Okay. All right. Letter B, we need to solve this one. So we say, what equation represents the line that passes through the point 1, negative 6 and negative 3, 10? First, we need to find our slope. So we do 10 minus negative 6 over negative 3 minus 1. 10 minus negative 6 is 16 over negative 4. When you reduce that, m is negative 4. So now we're going to plug that along with one of our coordinates into our equation. So we have 10 is equal to negative 4 times negative 3 plus b. So I've just substituted in 10 for y and negative 3 for x and negative 4 for b. So now I can solve this. 10 is equal to negative 4 times negative 3 is positive 12 plus b. Subtract 12 from both sides. Negative 2 is equal to b. So my equation is y equals negative 4x minus 2. Okay. Want you guys to go ahead and try letters A and B on your own. For letter A, we need to find our slope. So we do 8 minus 2 over 6 minus negative 3. 8 minus 2 is 6. 6 minus negative 3 is 9. And that fraction can be reduced to 2/3. So now we're going to plug in our points. We've got y equals mx plus b. So our y value is 8 is equal to our slope, 2/3 times our x value, 6 plus b. So 8 is equal to 2/3 times 6 is a positive 4 plus b. Subtract 4 from both sides. And 4 is equal to b. So our equation is y equals 2/3 x plus 4. Okay. Letter B, we need to find the slope of the line. So we do 8 minus negative 7 over 4 minus negative 1, which is 15 over 5, which reduces to 3. So we plug in our points. 8 is equal to 3 times 4 plus b. 3 times 4 is 12 plus b. We're going to subtract 12 from both sides. Negative 4 is equal to b. So my equation is y equals 3x minus 4. All right. Moving on to problem number 5. We need to graph a linear equation that is in slope-intercept form. So the first thing we're going to do is we know our slope is negative 3. Our y-intercept is at positive 4. So I'm going to put a point at the y-intercept, which is positive 4. And if our slope is negative 3, we can think of that as being negative 3 over 1. So we're going to go down 3 and to the right 1. So we go down 1, 2, 3 points and to the right 1. Down 1, 2, 3 to the right 1. Down 1, 2, 3 to the right 1. Alright, so now you can see why I may have told you to leave these in fraction form, because this allows us to just be able to graph very easily what our slopes are. Now we need to use a straight edge and connect all of our dots to the edges of the grid, arrows on both ends. and that is our slope. Okay. Letter B, we're going to do the same thing. Our y-intercept is at negative 8, so we have a point down here at negative 8. And our slope is a positive 1/2, so we are going to go up 1 and to the right 2. Up 1 to the right 2. Up 1 to the right 2. Up 1 to the right 2. So again, use a straight edge. Make sure it covers the edges of the grid, and you've got arrows on both ends. Okay? So once again, we got two slopes that are, one is this is positive. We're going up as we go from left to right. This one's negative. We're going down as we go left to right. All right, why don't you guys give the next two a try on your own, and we will go over them. So, letter A, we have a slope of negative 3/2 and a y-intercept at positive 2. So we start off with a point at positive 2. And our slope is negative 3/5. So we're going to go down 1, 2, 3 to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Down 1, 2, 3 to the right, 5. And we just need to connect our dots, make a nice straight line. Okay. So we have a straight line. You should always give yourself at least 3 points in order to make sure that your line is nice and straight. Okay. Letter B, we have a y-intercept at negative 5, so I'm going to put a point at negative 5. And we have a slope of a positive 4. So we're going to go up 4 and to the right 1. And go up 1, 2, 3, 4 to the right 1. Up 1, 2, 3, 4 to the right 1. And now we just connect our dots with a straight edge. Okay. Arrows on the end of your line, and it should extend beyond the edges of your grid. Okay? Moving on to problem number 6, modeling a function. A plumber charges a $65 fee for a repair plus $35 per hour. Write an equation to model the total cost y of the repair that takes x hours, and what is the graph? So, my fixed amount is going to be my y-intercept, and my per hour charge is going to be my slope. So we have $35 per hour times the number of hours it takes plus $65 for the call fee. So let's graph a couple points. First one, we're starting at $65. So we have 40, 50, 60, 5. All right, and 1 hour of work is going to be 65 plus 35, which is $100. So you have a point right there at 100. We've got, we can go up, and if we go with 3 hours of work, we're going to have a point at $180. So there's just a couple random points. You could plug in anything you want into this. Or you could use the trick of going up 35 and over 1. So we're sitting here at 65, so up 35, 65. Here's 5, 15, 25, 35 over 1. So if we would do that again, we go up 10, 20, 35 over 1. So we would have a point right about there. Pay attention to what your scale is on your graph. And we need to graph our line. All right, now, what does a good graph need? We need to have our labels. So we have hours on our x-axis, and we have cost in $1 on our y. Okay. All right, I want you guys to try the second word problem. Carpenter charges a $45 fee plus $30 per hour for labor. Write an equation to model the cost and then graph the function. So we are charging a $45 fee, that's a fixed amount, and $30 per hour. When you're looking for your rate of change or your slope, you're looking for something that says per. Dollars per hour, miles per hour, feet per second, anything like that. So our equation is going to be y is equal to 30x plus 45. And our variables, we've got hours on the x-axis. We have cost in dollars on our y-axis. And now we need to graph our points. So we have a $45 fee just for showing up. Each of your grid lines is going by 10, so it's going to be halfway between 40 and 50. And let's see, after 2 hours of work, we're adding $60 to it. So we're going to have 40 plus 60, or 45 plus 60, which is 105. So 80, 90, 100, 105. And after 4 hours of work, we're going to add another $60. So 105 plus 60 is 165. So there's our 3 points that we can use to graph. And if we use our straight edge, we have a line. Now, if you'll notice, I'm not drawing my line into my negative territory. Why would that be? Well, can't have negative hours, and I can't have negative cost. So I'm not going to need quadrants 2 or 3 or 4 at all for this graph. Okay? All right, so make sure you guys fill out the bottom half of this page, your level of understanding, and also write down any questions you may have come up with while we were working with this equation, and fill out that summary of what you learned today. All right, see you in class. Have a great night.